Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'd like you to meet the M1913 Bayonet, a full 15 inches long. Let me see if I can get it up there for you. Just an awesome bayonet. Very, very sturdy. And if you'd like to hear more about this and maybe some of the history that goes along with this, check out the video.
Throw them away, and I was like, wait. She goes, what? I said, give me those ketchups.
You wanted them condiments?
Yes. She didn't understand. She didn't, I mean, we barely know each other. She didn't.
You stole some woman's ketchup?
No, they were my ketchup. But they were extra ketchup that I didn't use, and I wanted to keep them.
Why were you asking her?
Because she took my tray.
Oh,
and my ketchup was on the tray, and I was like, wait a minute, I need that ketchup before you throw away my stuff, because I keep things like that. She goes, what do you mean? I said, condiments. She goes, why? I said, because I like to keep them. They're mine. And then I told her how you threw away my bag of condiments at home one time, and I got really mad.
And what'd she say?
She said, you ain't right.
All right, welcome back to the channel. Just like to say hi to all my viewers. Bonjour, privet, guten tag, hola and ciao to my foreign viewers. And we got kind of a foreign flair going on here today. Kind of a little Spanish layout, little Spanish bottle here. This is from Spain. I can't remember what this wine is, by the way, but I think it came from Rota, Spain. Anyhow, we're going to be talking about this fantastic M1913 bayonet. And let me just refer to my notes and get out some stuff here to you. So this bayonet overall is 20.5 inches long from tip to heel, and that's 521 millimeters. And the blade length is 15.625 inches, 397 millimeters. And so, put that aside and zoom. All right, so really big bayonet here, and those big bayonets are so cool. You've got a carbon steel collar on this with the frog. So this was meant to use with the frog. And there's the tip pinned in. And the leather is still intact. And that's just phenomenal. It's kind of delicate. I've restored it somewhat. But it is still there. And here's that big, beautiful blade. Whoa, more. Oh, there it is. Okay. And that's a big blade. And I would hate to be fighting that on the tip of a long rifle. And look at this blade. So before we talk about it, that's a walnut, checkered walnut. And can you believe that you have this checkering on a military bayonet? That just blows me away. It's one of the things that blew me away when I got this, was this is just really fine checkering. Beautifully done. Look how it's cut in here. And this is a military bayonet. So this was made in Toledo, the armory in Toledo. And it's called an M1913 because that was its inception date, 1913. That the knife was designed for a couple different rifles. One was a model M1895, the old bolt action Mauser, and the shortened version of that Mauser was the M1916. I've got a picture of that up there showing you right now. And we call those Spanish Mausers. there's another variation of that. And so the one in the picture there, that Mauser is a Spanish Mauser. It's gone through the conversion from 8mm to 308, but it hasn't gone through the whole conversion. So there's the picture you're looking at now is an F8, and an F8 is kind of a cleaned up version of that Spanish Mauser. And that's what this knife bayonet went on. And that seems kind of incredible. So the Spanish Mauser is a carbine, roughly around 30 inches long, you know, similar to carbines of today. And this thing itself is 20 inches long. So, I mean, check out, I did a short video hooking this up to the carbine. So check that out when you're done looking at this video. And you can see how ridiculous this looks on that carbine. But that's where this blade went. If you look here, you'll see the PR8. And what that stands for is para... Let me look at my notes. Para Reformendo 8. And obviously, you know, that went on the F8. And so the F8 is the final version of that Spanish Mauser that I showed you. And those were reconfigured to the NATO rounds in the 1950s. So that's when my my Mauser dates to, my Spanish Mauser dates to that time frame. And this bayonet would have been used on it. And there's a shorter bayonet. I'll show you that in the video right now. And the shorter bayonet was to be used on a set me. And that was a German design that was not popular in Germany. And so the Spanish went ahead and bought the rights to that and started producing the Setme, which is a really popular knife nowadays. And it had that ridiculous bayonet on it. It was recurved, and the soldiers didn't like that bayonet at all. They said it wouldn't cut. It was worthless. And they liked these instead. So after a while, they probably cut some of these down. I don't know. But this just fits over the barrel right there. And then locked in right here. Right there. And just really good quality on this bayonet. Just blows me away. So originally in 1913, when this came out, as I mentioned, it was supposed to be on the 1895. That was the long version of the Mauser, which Spain had bought from Germany. A lot of countries did. The Mauser was widely exported. And the shortened version of it to use with the cavalry was the M1943. And what ended up is this bayonet actually went on to that shorter version, and that's where it was used. It wasn't used on the longer one. And that's really interesting right there. These things were used by the National Guard, Guardia Nacional of Spain. And the Spanish Mausers were used in the Spanish Revolution. And all the way up until the 1970s. So that's probably how I got this knife. I bought it surplus. And just really cool. Really cool. Oh, so I never explained that. So that picture I showed you before, I'll show you again. That's the picture is the original stamp from the M1913. So this is being reconditioned and put on the PR8. That's what this stands for. And so this was meant to be put on the short carbine bolt action rifles. That's how you know that. But it wasn't manufactured in the 50s. This was manufactured sometime after 1913. I don't know when, because I don't have the original markings on it, so I can't really trace it. Anyhow, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you found it informative. And really appreciate all that you guys do for the channel. If you'd like to see more content like this, go ahead and subscribe. Thanks again.